Matt Parker recently showed me this fact that seems completely wild. Say you sample two random numbers, each one uniform in the range from 0 to 1, and you compute their maximum. Then the result is, of course, another random number with this bias towards being larger. A seemingly completely different thing you could do would be to take one of those numbers and compute its square root. When you square a number that's smaller than 1, it becomes smaller, so that means when you take its square root, it becomes bigger. So this is another process that would give you a random value with a bias towards being larger. The surprise is that both of these are the same, in the sense that the distribution describing your result is identical for both of these procedures. At first, it just feels really wrong that computing a maximum and a square root could give you the same thing like this, but there's actually a really nice way to visualize why this should be true. Well, think about one of these random numbers as existing somewhere on an x-axis between 0 and 1, and the other random number is going to exist on a y-axis, again, uniform between 0 and 1. So thinking of the pair of these numbers as a set of coordinates, when you sample both at random, you're basically sampling a random point inside this 1x1 unit square. So take a moment to think about what it looks like for the maximum of these two values to be a particular number, like 0.7. Well, either x1 is equal to that value and x2 is smaller than it, which puts you somewhere on this line, or x2 equals that value and x1 is smaller than that, putting you somewhere on this line. In general, with continuous values, it's not very helpful to ask the probability of equaling a certain number, since the answer tends to be infinitesimal. But what is helpful is to ask the probability that your random value is less than or equal to a certain number. In this case, what it looks like to be less than or equal to, say, 0.7, is that you fall somewhere inside this square here. And so, because everything is uniform, the probability of landing in that region is the area of that region. And in general, the probability that this maximum is less than some number r looks like r squared. This actually has a fancy name. It's called the cumulative distribution function for the random variable. But now, think about the other case, where you're taking a square root. What is the probability that the square root of one of these values is less than some number r? That's the same thing as asking for the value itself to be less than or equal to r squared, and since it's all uniform, the answer there is again r squared. So both of these processes have the same cumulative distribution function, that's why they're identical. Essentially, identical reasoning will show that if you take the maximum of three such random variables, it has the same effect as taking the cube root of one of them.